Gem event, and on we are going to go. Actually, I think we even had a testimonial on this just a little earlier in the hour. So this is the first time it's back since June. Huge customer pick. And here you make the choice of either the orange spiny oyster.
Or the red.
Or the red. That's it. Or, okay. Or turquoise.
Well, it comes right. With turquoise in it.
Right, turquoise is in it. I think they have that. Is that how we place, I think, the order? Well, we'll verify that for everyone on that. But anyway, customer pick. And I love, love, love the length on this. Again, Jay, this is a full 60 inches in length.
So it's 5 feet. So it's as tall or taller than some of their show hosts here.
Yes.
I won't name any names. I'm not naming names, but I think we know who we're talking about,
exactly.
Right? It's one of my selling points that I do bring up with 60 inches. The reason we're doing 60 inches is because I gotta tell you, so many of our viewers request, they said, can you please do something even longer? Because I like to stay around 36 inches is kind of, you know, the longest I get. But so many people have asked for 60 inches. And the thing is on this, you've got so much to work with. So again, you have that versatility. You're making one purchase, you make one buy, but you're getting all these different looks that you can do with
it.
And it allows you to be your kind of like your own designer. Now, what makes this so unique and so special is this. It comes in, spiny oyster comes from one location in the world. It comes from the Baja Peninsula, well, in the Sea of Cortez, which, you know where the Baja is? Between the Baja and Mexico proper, that's the Sea of Cortez. That's where this is found. This is where spiny oyster is found. It comes in three colors. It comes in purple, orange, and red. So we have it in the orange, and we have it in the red. The orange is...
And I think it's Chilean. I'm sorry. So I guess you place your order either orange or Chilean. That's what they're calling it.
Well, the Chilean is a turquoise.
I know. I'm really sorry. I didn't do that. I'm only conveying the information.
Okay. Well, here's the thing. They both come with Chilean turquoise.
Okay. So
okay. They both come with Chilean turquoise, but your choices are either, okay, but it's the red spiny or the orange spiny.
So Chilean, if you want the red spiny.
Then you can call it Chilean?
That's what we're doing.
Okay.
Thank you.
As long as you're okay with it, I'm good with it.
Exactly, we're good with it too.
So what's cool about this is this brings back so many memories, all right? When I was in college, I did go to New Mexico State, Las Cruces, and we used to go down, and back then, the stuff that we did that you can't, I mean, you try to do this stuff today, I mean, it probably, you know, you wouldn't be able to do it. You'd probably get arrested.
You'd be behind bars, right?
But back then it was legal. But we used to all go down there. There were a group of us. We were all scuba divers. So we had a friend that had this old Volkswagen van. And we would take this Volkswagen van, we'd load all of our scuba gear, all of our tanks and everything.
Right.
We would go down to San Carlos, Guaymas in Mexico, that's on the Pacific side. And we would go, all we would take, to be honest with you, is a cooler of beer and some matches.
What else do you need?
We slept on the beach, but we dove for our food. So we would spear fish and everything, that's how we did it. Well, on the beach, in the early 70s, there would be piles of spiny oyster on the beach. You would just find piles of it. And the reason they call it spiny oyster, it's an oyster, an actual oyster, but it's got spines on it. It looks like a porcupine almost. It'll draw blood. So what the locals were doing is they were diving for this and they were harvesting the oysters, right, to eat. I mean, you know, they would sell the oysters or whatever
you could eat.
But they had no
interest in the.
They had no use for the shell at all. So us being young, enterprising people, and we were all bead makers and stuff like that, and we were cutting beads and stuff, and we said, oh, God, free, you know? So we would load this van up. Now think about this. We'd go back loaded with this van, right? No permits, no nothing.
Oh, my.
And we'd drive across the border, and they would let you go. Well, after a while, every time we went back down there, all of a sudden there's no shell on the beach anymore. They figured out that we were starting making jewelry out of it, and now it's selling. This is highly controlled.
Amazing.
And it's really getting rare that you can do it. You have to be grandfathered in. There's only 12 families that are allowed to deal with it.
No kidding. I love it. So the red Chilean option is the most popular. Great. I love your stories, Jay.
Okay. And Chilean turquoise, you see that bright blue?
Yes.
So if you say Chilean, you